event that we have organized this evening on behalf of Victoria Memorial Hall. We are going to recall Jewish Calcutta. At the very outset, I would like to request our colleagues from the Victoria Memorial Hall, Mr. Shakil Ahmed, the administrative officer, to hand over a bouquet to felicitate Yael Suleiman, please. And Sumaya and Shilpi, to do the honor to Mrs. Joe Cohen. Sorry for adding the E to your name. Everyone does that. And Mr. G.M. Kapoor. And Professor Amlan Dasgupta. So felicitations in place. May I now request Mr. Shakil Ahmed, administrative officer, to welcome the gathering here. Our secretary and curator had to undertake a journey today. So please, Mr. Shakil Ahmed.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you all on behalf of Victoria Memorial to the illustrated lecture of recalling the Jewish Calcutta by Dr. Yael Suleiman. As you know, she did a momentous work of collating all the information on the Jewish community in Calcutta and putting it on a digital archive. I thank her for agreeing to give a lecture today. The other speakers, as you know, are Mr. Adam Gorodsky, Executive Director, US India Educational Foundation, Mr. G.M. Kapoor of INTAC, West Bengal chapter, and Professor Anand Das Gupta of the School of Cultural Text and Records, Jadavpur University. They have individually and on behalf of their respective organization had assisted Dr. Suleiman in this project. I thank them all for taking the time out of their busy schedule and agreeing to remain present here as speakers. I also thank Mrs. Joe Cohen. She is representing the Jewish community in Calcutta, and she will share her experience with us today. I thank you all of you for coming here, for making this program a successful one. So more or less, the stage is set for an enlightening evening. Over to Mr. Raman for carrying this program forward. Thank you.
Carrying this program forward, we shall at a fast pace. Of course, there are some people standing at the back without seats yet, and we are trying to organize some chairs. Just bear with us. Till then, just stand at the back. Some chairs will be coming in a short while. We didn't expect so many people to come this evening, and this room also has a capacity of only about 130 people. May I now, without any further ado, request Mr. Adam Grofsky to start the proceedings this evening. All the speakers who are listed here will make brief remarks about their association with the project. And of course, the main presentation will be by Yael Suleiman. Please, Mr. Grofsky.
Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. Again, my name is Adam Grodsky, and I represent the United States India Educational Foundation. Many of you may know us by our earlier incarnation as USEFI, or the United States Educational Foundation in India. We're the same organization, only now with the generous support of the Indian government, alongside, of course, with the US government, now offering Fulbright Nehru grants here in India. Since 1950, USIEF has awarded over 18,000 fellowships to Indian and to American citizens in a wide range of disciplines, in the sciences, the humanities, social sciences, and in the fine arts. And over the years, we've had a number of artists researching and artists and researchers documenting the Jewish community in India, including recently Siona Benjamin, as well as Satya Shepherd, who wrote of her experiences in the book Girl from Foreign. But to my knowledge, Yael Suleiman is the first that is first of all, writer that is working and researching the Jewish community here in Kolkata. Yael has been working on this archive for a long time, long before her association with USIEF. But recently, last year, USIEF decided to continue to fund her research in this important area through a Fulbright Nehru Academic and Professional Excellence Award. It's my understanding that over the next year, she'll be interviewing dozens of aging non-Jews here in Kolkata who have had a close association with the Jewish community. And in this way, she will bring this perspective to her work on the Jewish community here in India. And for this reason, USIEF decided to fund her on her project to further build this archive of important work. I'm very thrilled to be here this evening, thrilled to be supporting Yael and her work, and look forward to hearing more about that work this evening. With that, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Alan Grotsky. May I now request Mr. G.M. Kapoor, representing Intact West Bengal chapter, to make his brief remarks.
Good evening, friends. My association with this project is more as a moral supporter to Yael than anything else. In fact, anything to do with heritage, we offer our full support all the time. And we are delighted that she has taken this step, and I would think that a lot more communities should do it before their memories fade out. Because even in our families, we find that if once the grandmother and the grandfather are gone, a lot of memories just get wiped out, and you don't even see old photographs, you can't recognize people, and there's nobody to tell you who that person is. So this, I really admire the effort which she has made. And I would like to mention that the digital archive focuses on an ethnic community, in this case the Jewish community. It will help us to understand the dynamics of a complex and ever-changing city. In fact, the earlier Jewish settlers formed what may be called an ethnic enclave in and around the area where the synagogues are located, as names like Ezra Street, Pollock Street, Manuk Lane, etc. all suggest. And an ethnic enclave can be defined as a small area of the city that is dominated by people of one particular ethnic or linguistic group or religion. Such an area can be a window to the city's history and important urban processes that the city has experienced. An ethnic enclave can change with time, either becoming stronger in its distinct identity, or it can slowly disappear, merging with the rest of the city, as has happened with the Jewish enclave. Ethnic enclaves add to a city's cultural and social diversity, and in thriving communities are an important ingredient of the heterogeneity and the pluralism of a city. Kolkata has seen people from many lands come and settle, including Europeans, Armenians, Jews, and Chinese. Over the course of the last 6 decades, most of these transnational groups have left. As such, a digital archive of the communities is a major step which Ms. Silliman has taken to preserve this heritage. At least the next generation will know that this was part of the city's multinational, multicultural heritage, and also understand the immense contribution which the community has made to the city's growth and development in various facets. We in Intech have been working on urban regeneration projects connected to the Chinese community and are aware of the difficulties one faces in accessing archival material, in spite of the fact there are far more numbers in the Chinese community than there are in the Jewish community. I can well imagine the trials and tribulations which Yael has had to go through to complete the archive, but she has done yeoman service to the heritage and history of the city, for which we must all congratulate her. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. G.M. Kapoor, who started out by saying that all he has done is just lend moral support. Moral of the story is the moral support is very much necessary in such initiatives. And with that, I would like to request Professor Amlan Das Gupta, of Jadavpur University, who has been very closely associated with this project of Yael Silliman, to kindly mention about their association and how it worked.
Good evening. Our association with this project, my association with this project, has been fairly close, and I'd just like to say very briefly of the way it developed. A little more than a year ago, I think, Yael, it seems a long time, but it's really not that long. I had the privilege of meeting Yael, and she proved a common acquaintance. And she spoke about her wish to create an archive or some kind of site which would record the history of Jewish, the Jewish community in Kolkata. We at Jadavpur University, at that time I was heading the School of Cultural Texts and Records, and we have worked on various digitization projects of large, both large and small, different kinds, textual digitization, music digitization is another big area of ours. But archiving the history of a community is something that we thought would be a new kind of challenge, and so we, you know, scraped some funds together from somewhere. And in this, I would like to thank, and I'm sure I will add a thanks to the Sir Ratan Tata Trust, who put under whose project we were able to place this work, and thus pay some money to our young workers who worked under Yael's guidance and started amassing material, to say photographic records, some video clips, and also creating digital images of those marvelous sets of photographs, letters, memorabilia, educational records. It's really lovely. And albums, which used to come, she used to bring in, and we used to make high quality images. And the point I'd like to stress here is that the School of Cultural Texts currently holds the whole set of these of high quality images. The website, of course, has access images which can be seen and used for all practical purposes. But if there is any researcher who needs particularly to consult these high quality images, if Yael permits, to say, if the permission of the creator of the archive, they are welcome to come and use it. Using, of course, is easy. Don't even need much permission to use the archive, but for other reasons it may be necessary to take permission. So it was an important addition to the kind of archives that we already had, and it has received a good deal of attention. There's a couple of more things I'd just like to say. Is one is that, in some sense, this is an archive of memories. It's, these images, paper documents that we photographed, speak of the thriving life of a community which over time has shrunk and dwindled. It remains very much in our memories, those of us who have lived in this city for a long time. Those of an earlier generation will have even more intimate memories of the way in which this city was truly a city in which different communities interacted with each other. It was truly a city in which there was this layering of different communities. We thought at that time that perhaps the Jewish History Project would lead to other, us being able to archive the history of other communities, and we have preliminary talks with the IL in this regard too. Perhaps it will still happen, hoping it will happen. Whoever does it, academic institutions, people change, but the work goes on, so I hope that whoever takes this work up will continue to do this work. I'd like to end by thanking my young research staff, who did a marvelous job, and I'm sure a great deal of initiative. Two of them are sitting in the back, they refuse to come up front. Others are working, earning livings, they say, elsewhere. Antarit couldn't come because he's stuck in office. And another of our young workers who was associated as a web designer, he's ex-student of university and ex-worker of the School of Cultural Texts and Records, is currently in Dublin working for a PhD, and he designed the website. So